Salman is that he has been doing too much too fast in a conservative regime. Do you think that's the case?
No, I think on the contrary, country requires and it's a necessity to keep up. What it wants to do, Vision 2030, is exactly what it needs to do. So, to me, it came to no surprise that Mohammed bin Salman is the crown prince. It happened before in terms of changes. Prince Mohammed, who was the crown prince, was replaced by Muhammad bin Nayef, the outgoing crown prince. Now we have changes again. And really simply to me, it shows that there is clarity and continuity when it comes to being about the war project. This is a 31-year-old crown prince who will be around, sticking around, at the economic reforms that he actually set as the principal issues for this country to be moving ahead. So it's very important that we have a young person who will be leading the efforts, and now he's the crown prince.
John, we are also hearing, though, that the Saudi king has restored all state employees' benefits. The fact that they actually went ahead and did that, is that an indication that the salary cuts came too quickly, that perhaps the progress that they were expecting from reforms isn't coming quick enough?
I think they were reinstated because they served the purpose to narrow the fiscal gap. The gap in 2016 in terms of the fiscal deficit was 17%. That was addressed by these cuts. They're not exceptionally popular in Saudi Arabia. However, now that oil has recovered, albeit still at $45-$47 a barrel, the fiscal deficit seems to be narrowing. It's not a huge problem for Saudi Arabia in 2017. So they have been reinstated because it is a stimulus to the economy. Consumption is close to 50% of the